Hello students, today we are going to see the topic Introduction to Ergonomics. I am Professor K. Kalidas to handle the session for you. So what is meant by ergonomic? Ergons means work, nomos means natural laws. So it is the study of the relationship between a man and his working environment. So it is also called as the human engineering. If the working environment does not support a labor, then obviously his efficiency will get reduced. So it is just fitting the job for a worker. So it is nothing but the ergonomics. So, ergonomic study involves the knowledge of the psychologist, physiologist, anatomist, engineer, anthropologist, and biometrician. Who are they? Who are they? So, we are going to have all this study. So, a psychologist deals with human mind and its functions. Does he have any mental stress while doing the problem or not? Does he get fatigue in doing the particular work or not? So all this has to be analyzed, and the facilitation has to be given in the workplace through this ergonomic design. The physiologist deals with the function of human and their parts. So obviously in an industry, especially in the manufacturing sectors, the two hands that you are going to use plays a major role. So whether you are overloading your hands while doing a particular process or not, so that is nothing but the physiologist. So it means the physical working of that particular human has been analyzed. Then go for the anatomists. So anatomy is nothing but the body structures of a human. While doing that work, whether any body structure change will occur or not. Sometimes what happens, your neck may pain, your legs may pain, your hands may pain. So there is some internal structural change in the bones or in the muscles. So that is dealt with by the anatomy. An engineer, he deals only with the production process. So ultimately, he is the guy who is going to solve all these problems of the worker and make him to work in an efficient manner. Then anthropologist deals with the measurement of human individual. So for every human, there is something called as the workspace. It means the maximum extent that the hands can move and the maximum extent that the legs can move. So that is the 360 degree workspace. So he deals with what is the distance that has to be maintained between that particular worker and particular machine so that he can work in a comfortable manner. For a simple example, you can say, what should be the height of the chair while sitting before a computer so that the vision will be parallel to your eyesight. So these are dealt by the anthropologist. Then biometrician, he deals with the application of statistical analysis to biological data. He says, suppose if you work for this much time, you will get fatigue. If you work for this much time in the radiation environment, you may get some troubles. So all this biomedical analysis will be given by the biometrician. So as said, the ergonomics combines the knowledge of all these guys. So what is the objective? So to optimize the integration of man and machine in order to increase the work rate and the efficiency. So I should love my place of work. So I'm working in a machine, I should love that. So there should be an integration. Then it involves the design of the workplace benefiting the needs and requirement of the. A simple example, the water should be nearby to drink, and the tool should be available near to my hands to work it. So all this for the needs of the worker. So the design of the workplace should be inappropriate with the needs. It involves the design of the equipment, machinery, and control to minimize the mental and physical strain of the worker. Say, for example, you want to tighten and loosen up a product. If you are using manual method, then obviously it will increase the physical strain of a worker. So there I can use some automatic machines so that the tightening and loosening of a particular nut or the bolt will be easier for me. So wherever possible, I have to minimize the particular physical strain of the worker. Then it involves the design of conducting environment for executing the task more effectively. Conductive, in the sense, the relative environment. If you want to say something, I should say. If you want to communicate to a manager or a supervisor, I should communicate in an easy way. So that environment should be available. So ergonomic design takes care of all the physical and mental strains of the worker. So where are the application area? So it is in the normal working environment. It can help you in the particular place where you work. Say, for example, if you work in a lathe, so the space around that particular lathe is called as the working environment. So ergonomics is applied there. Or the entire workplace layout, the entire machine shop can be modified with respect to ergonomic design. Then other considerable areas like fatigue, rest pauses, this is the time taken for rest, then shift changes, age consideration. So all this will be considered during the ergonomic design. So in this lecture, we have seen a brief introduction to ergonomics in an industry. Thank you.